going to next topic. Next topic is regarding incineration. From the word, hearing the word incineration, we can see it is a type of combustion. You can see in detail what is meant by incineration. Next is incineration. Incineration means it is a type of waste treatment technology which is mainly comprises of combustion of waste, and this combustion is used to recover the energy, and this entire process is known as incineration. This incineration is usually done at very high temperature and which needs some thermal treatment also. This method can convert the waste into either ash or gas or in the form of heat, and this will reduce the entire mass of the waste to up to 96%. This is mainly popular in different countries like Japan, where there is a scarcity of land, and it can be seen that about 4.8% of electricity can be produced by using this incineration method, and most of the countries are also practicing the same. So the main objective of incineration is to reduce the volume reduction. As we already discussed, thus it can reduce the volume mass about 96%. And the next is stabilization of waste. That means the waste which is produced, or the ash which is produced from the incineration plant, is always an inert one, which will reduce the hazard of land. The other main reason for incineration is we can recover lot of energy from the waste, and this energy can be utilized for other purposes, and also in case of biomedical waste or clinical waste, we can be sterilize the waste using this incineration. Then we can see an incineration plant in the next slide. Moving on to the next, incineration produces different types of gases like carbon dioxide, carbon monoxide, oxygen, water and sulfur dioxide, but the final ash is always an inert residue or inert material. Therefore we can re-sterilize the waste, and it will also cause less hazard to the environment. Moving on to the type of incineration, there are different types of incineration based on their purpose. It can be either domestic, it can be either commercial or municipal. This domestic incinerator means they are used mainly for the domestic purpose. It can be a very small quantity. This capacity is absolutely 50 kilograms per hour. But this commercial incinerator, it means it is of medium capacity, which is up to 500 kg per hour, and municipal incinerator means it is for high capacity, it is above 500 kg per hour. Then based on the number of chambers, it can be either a single chamber or it can be a multi-chamber, which can be discussed in the next slide. Next is single chamber. In single chamber, there is only a single number of chambers for the entire process, but in case of multiple chambers, it can be more than one chamber, where the first chamber is used, or the primary chamber is mainly used for incineration after drying, and after removal of this moisture, this entire thing is transferred into another pot, which is has high velocity of heat, in which all the materials will burn. The next one is based on technology. First one is mass burning system. It can be either refuse derived fuel system or modular incineration or fluidized bed incineration. Well, this modular and mass burning systems are mainly used. First one is mass burning system, which consists of a system with liner, with water wall steam generator. It is a multi-chamber with half more, two or more chambers, which can produce up to 50 to 100 tons per day capacity. So this is an example of multi-chamber incinerator, in which there is three chambers are there. In the first chamber, is a large area in which person is living that right, and it will pass into the next chamber, and again this material will pass into the third one where the mixing will take place. These are interconnected by gas passages and gas will finally collected as a using scrubbers. The next is retrotype. Retrotype is capacity is less than 350 kg per hour, and the arrangement of chamber is that this gases change direction by 90 degrees both in lateral as well as vertical direction to return flow of gases. A common wall is used between primary and secondary chamber, and there is also mixing of gases is taking place at 1:1 ratio, 2.4:1 ratio. And the main thing for remembering is that the thickness of the wall, which determine the mixing and compression capacity. The next is implant type. It is already discussed here. It is a multi-type chamber, and in this gas will revolve only in 90 degrees in vertical direction only, but in other cases will turn both in horizontal as well as direction, horizontal as well as vertical direction. And this here the mixing is 2:1 to 5:1. This is the figure of inclined chamber. It is also multi chamber. There is an inlet as well as outlet. And in the first chamber, the sludge will retain for some days or some time, and this is kept for drying, and this will pass into the second chamber. The figure is very, very important, so you have to study the figure also. Next one is refuse-derived fuel, which means any fuel which is derived from this waste or derived from some refuse. It is mainly derived or processed from mechanically, and which is used for any other purpose. Yeah, it has two components. There is an RDF production as well as RDF incineration. In RDF production, makes RDF in various forms through material separation, size reduction and pelletizing, which we already discussed in the earlier classes. Then RDF incineration, which we will see using a flow diagram. This is the RDF incineration. First, the truck will dump all the waste into a primary shredder, which reduce the size or shred the waste materials, and which will move into the magnetic separator where we remove all the ferrous materials. And again, these materials are shredded, or they will reduce the volume into required sizes and move into a bin where the boiler will act, and it converts heat into ashes as well as heat. The heat will move into the filter, and it will be used for some purpose. The next one is modular combustion units. Modular combustion units, so they are very small burn plants. Their capacity is 25 to 300 tons per day. And mainly they are ready-made combustion units, which will prepare in one site and move into the required places. Next, moving to the waste incineration technology, there are certain methods for the incineration of waste. First one is combustion, which means primary heating. Second one is pyrolysis, and last one is gasification. Combustion is a very simple process, and the cost is very less. It is conventionally practiced, and it is the most effective way, which we have used nearly times only. Then moving to the disadvantages, which will cause so many pollutants like carbon dioxide, carbon monoxide. These are all very harmful things, and the moving of waste is very difficult. Then moving to the next one, pyrolysis. It is an irreversible chemical change, and with the help of oxygen, it is also known as destructive distillation or carbonization. It is carried at 100 degrees Celsius. This liquid have very high heating value. It can be used as a fuel. is mainly known as the decomposition, thermal decomposition of organic material with the addition of oxygen, and which takes place at very high temperature. It is an endothermic process, and it is mainly heated in a specially designed chamber, and the heating is also carried at very close chamber at about 650 degrees Celsius to 100 degrees Celsius. The main end product is methane, carbon monoxide, oil, etc. So these are some of the reactions of incineration which take place. First one is in all the reactions, the end and proper end item is heat. And this will cause so many problems because there is a partial decomposition will take place and cause carbon monoxide, formaldehyde, methanol, etc. Pyrolysis can be either at very high temperature or can be at low temperature. Low temperature means at 500 degrees Celsius. It is high temperature means at 1000 degrees Celsius. The main products of pyrolysis, it can be either a gas, it can be either a liquid, or it can be either a solid. Moving on to the advantages of pyrolysis, then there are some certain conditions for thermal decomposition, mean temperature and pressure, conditions for burning, there are conditions for conversion as well as there are some gaseous pollutants also. And disadvantages, it means it has very less capacity, less efficiency, more sophisticated machines are required, it is more expensive than the other combustion. In gasification, the end product is a gas. Mainly there is a conversion of waste into valuable products, and mainly they are producing syngas. And it is a safe landing for gases also. Moving to disadvantages, the main disadvantages is use very sophisticated equipment and it is a very less capacity and it is also very expensive. Moving to the advantages of incineration. Incineration is a very efficient way which reduces the waste volume as well as it can be used for the landfill process also. And it reduces the cost of food transportation, also reduces the need for landfill, and this slag should be verified before it is used. The energy can be recovered, and it also helps to eliminate methane gas emissions, and this will produce a substitute for fossil fuel combustion, and this will reduce the greenhouse gas emission and reduce the volume by 95%. Moving to the disadvantages, not all waste can be burnt. This waste can be burnt just based on the moisture content. And thus, during incineration, large number of toxic chemicals have been released to the atmosphere, which again causes air pollution. And the disposal of the entire end product like ash, it is very difficult. And this also needs high investment as well as operating cost. And since it is a complex process, it needs skilled staff also.